Endorsed by Novak Djokovic, Head makes some subtle updates in the new Graphene 360 Plus Speed Pro. Updated in 2020 with Graphene 360 Plus, this racket rewards big swings as the 100 square inch head and 18 by 20 string pattern comes paired with an RA of 62, a 23 millimeter beam, and a swing weight of 329. Weighing in at 11.6 ounces strong, it will swing slightly heavier than the previous model. It also distinguishes itself from the previous version by offering more power and stability. First up, we have Chris. Now, how did the Speed Pro work for your versatile game?
I really enjoyed it. It's got a lot more feel in it, I think, in this update, and I felt really connected. I loved it at net. It's probably my favorite thing was hitting volleys with this racket. Felt super dialed in. There's enough mass and stability here, more so than you get from the MP version, which I was also a big fan of, and that helped me punch the ball deep. It also kept the racket really stable, so on those drop volleys, I could go with a super loose grip, get maximum feel, and I just really enjoyed the response of the racket there. From the baseline, I thought it came through with the kind of mass that I like. It's definitely a spec that I can play with, so super quick to get used to it. The string pattern is the same as my racket too, so I felt dialed in again very quickly. This one does give me a slightly higher launch angle than I'm used to out of my regular racket, so that helped me when I was in defensive situations. I could get the ball back deep and with some added pace with less effort, so that was super nice. And there was a little bit more pop when I stepped inside the court to help me put the ball away. So really fun playtest for me. I think it's a great update. And I have to say, it's most definitely my favorite version of the Speed Pro to date.
Next up, we have Boonie. Now, I know you've played with many iterations of the Speed. How did the Speed Pro update work for your game?
Yeah, it's been a pretty fortunate playtest scenario for me, all the way from the UTEC when it had a 16-19 pattern, all the way straight through to now. So from the Graphene version on, I've really enjoyed this racket, especially from the backcourt. And as soon as the touch version came out, they kind of spread out that 18-20 a little bit, making access to spin that much easier. And then from the two successors after that, they gradually got a little heavier. So this racket to me is very solid, easy power. That's one of our favorite phrases of a customer Troy and I are familiar with here. He likes to toss that out. This racket definitely qualifies. Very impressive. It's hard to tell if it's really the spiral fibers in the bottom portion of the throat or if it is actually the heavier swing weight and static weight, but it is definitely a more race-ready stick. This has got lots of plow through compared to the other ones, a little more stable. In terms of access to spin, you guys know my story. If it's got 18 mains, I'm gonna pair a sharp string with it. It gives me kind of that connected feeling of the 18 main. I still get that nice grip on the ball and the arc. So overall, for me, this is the best iteration of the frame thus far. Love the playtest.
Next up, we have Troy. Now, we've already heard some really positive comments from Mark and Chris. How did you like this iteration of the Speed Pro?
This update, the Graphene 360 Plus, it definitely falls more in line with the Graphene versions than it did with like the UTEC, the older models. Still has that kind of thicker beam, but the one thing I did like about it is that it is solid. It did have pretty decent stability. I felt like the last version, the Graphene 360, was a little faster and probably the most powerful Speed Pro I've ever played with. This one took it down a little bit in the power level and a little more control. I did like that they increased the swing weight a little bit, so it gave me a fast-feeling racket compared to what I usually play with, but still solid and stable on impact. And for having like that thicker beam, around a 23 millimeter beam, it still felt pretty low powered. I thought it was going to be more lively like the last one, and this one very much control-oriented. But I thought it was a spin-friendly 18-20. I liked it on serve, because I could really go after the flat one or hit the spin serve equally as effective. Up at net, I had enough touch and feel. So overall, I think it's a really user-friendly 100 square inch 18-20 racket, and it still had a decent amount of comfort and feel for me.
I'm a big fan of these 100 square inch rackets that still have a bit of a stiffer beam so I can generate that power, but then are paired with the 18 by 20 string pattern, because that's all the control I'm always asking for in these kind of rackets. So I really felt dialed in with my precision, and I felt I could swing out and was pretty confident that I wasn't going to be missing by too big of margins. So that made it really fun to play test this racket. I had one small knock. There was a tiny bit of stability issue for me with this racket, and some of my opponents did notice that as well, mainly when I was transitioning to hit a bigger shot or attack the ball and move forward, just a tiny bit of instability at the end of my stroke. Definitely able to fix that with a little weight and a little customization, so no issues there. But at net, as Chris mentioned, super flawless to volley with, really solid, stable up at net, no stability issues there. And as Troy mentioned, I actually really was dialed in on my serve. I felt like I could pinpoint my targets and really attack and go after big first serves. So all in all, I really enjoyed this playtest. We play tested this racket with two new strings from Head, which we really enjoyed, Lynx Tour and Lynx Edge, and we tried them both at 52 pounds. For more information about this racket and many others, please visit us at Tennis Warehouse, Tennis Warehouse Europe, or Tennis Only.